Hey everyone, I'm Alex Noonan. I'm a developer advocate here at Dagster Labs, and today I'm going to be talking about asset factories. So at Dagster, we talk a lot about bringing software engineering best practices to data engineering. But what does that actually mean? At a high level, you have CI/CD, testing, environment setup, data quality, and code organization. Today, I'm going to show you an example of using a factory pattern in Dagster to dynamically create assets which result in code and data assets that are uniform and scalable. Factory patterns are familiar to you if you come from a software engineering background, but essentially you are outlining a blueprint to create Dagster abstractions like assets, sensors, and jobs to conform to your data platform. For example, our DBT integration uses a factory pattern that takes in your DBT models, their metadata, and how they're related, and builds them into your asset graph. In this example, I'm going to build a simple asset factory that takes in multiple CSVs from a Google Drive and saves them to a DuckDB database, and then builds a sensor that checks to see if that file was updated or new files were added, and then updates the database tables. So without further ado, let's jump into it. So we have all of our CSVs in our Google Drive folder, and the first thing we need to do is we need to authenticate through GCP and create a service account that can access these files. So inside Google Cloud Platform, I'm in IAM and I need to create a service account. So we're going to do that right here. And we are going to create one called Asset Factory Example. We are going to give it the basic viewer role because it just wants to look at the files and we don't need to do any editing. Next, we need to create a key for this service account. We're going to create a JSON file and add this to our environment variables. And then for the last step, we need to get the email for this service account and we need to share the Google Drive folder with it. And there's no need to notify since it's a robot. And the last thing we need to do is we need to get the ID for this folder and add that to our environment variables as well. So here we are inside VS Code and we have our project set up. In the PyProject file, we have the packages we need for this. So we're going to create a new virtual environment and then we're going to install the package to get our dependencies. And now we're going to import all our dependencies. So first thing we're going to do is create a model for our drive files, which have some metadata associated to it. And then next, we're going to create a class to manage the state for our Google Drive client, as well as a few functions here for interacting with Google Drive, such as getting the file, listing all the files in the drive, getting the specific file metadata, and then getting the data from that file. Next thing we're going to do is create our Google Drive Dagster resource. And this is just a wrapper above the class that we created above. It takes in the JSON credentials and it initializes the class. Now the functions for this resource mirror the class above. So nothing crazy here. The next thing we're going to do is create our asset factory. So for that, we're going to take in a drive file as well as Google Drive resource, and we're going to return a definitions object. So here we're pulling out the file name and file ID from that drive file asset, and now we're creating the asset here. So the kinds are, it uses polars, DuckDB, and the Google Drive resource, so we want to annotate that above. Thank you.
Now, because we did the hard work above in our Google Drive resource, actually getting the data is pretty straightforward. We're just requesting the binary for the file, decoding it into a CSV, loading it into a Polar's data frame, and then dropping or creating the table in DuckDB. And then we're going to print some metadata when we materialize this. Next thing we're going to do is create a job for the sensor, which is basically just selecting the asset we created above. And now we're onto the sensor for this. So the behavior that we want to have happen is if the file is new or has been updated since the last run, we want to send a run request to that job above to rematerialize the asset. And then to finish off our asset factory, we're going to create a definitions object from the asset job and sensor we created above. Next, we're going to initialize our Google Drive resource, define the folder that we want to search, and then we are going to create the asset factory from all the files in that folder. Then we're going to create our definitions object, and we're going to fire up Dagster Dev to launch our web server. So now that we're in Dagster, let's look at the sensors and assets that we created from our asset factory, and then the corresponding jobs. Next, we're going to turn on these sensors, and they will initiate the runs to populate our database. So we're going to run these one at a time because we're running DuckDB locally and we didn't do any additional configuration to handle the concurrency. Now that all of our assets are materialized, we're going to upload a new version of the state dataset to make sure our sensor works. And as expected, a run was initiated for that file to rematerialize.
I hope you enjoyed that example of asset factories in Dagster. The code for that project is in the description, and make sure you subscribe to our channel and join our Slack community so you don't miss any updates. Thank you.